Hello students, today we are going to see similarity of triangles and also solve some of the examples from exercise 6.3. So let's start with our today's topic. Now, what is similarity of the two triangles? We know what is mean by the similar triangles. If two triangles are look alike but different in their sizes, then those two triangles will be called as similar triangles. And we have seen if two triangles, for example, in this two triangle ABC and triangle DEF, if let me write triangle ABC, triangle DEF, if corresponding angles are congruent, that means angle A and angle D is congruent, that is equal, angle B is equals to angle E, angle C is equals to angle F, then these two triangles will be called as similar triangle by using angle property or criteria, right? And also, if corresponding two sides ratio is equal, that is corresponding sides are proportional, then those two triangles are also called as similar by using SSS criteria. And there is also one criteria to explain this or to check whether the two triangles are congruent or not, that we are going to see. So the first criteria is written in the form of theorem 6.3 in textbook. If in two triangles corresponding angles are equal, though, and their then their corresponding sides are in same ratio, and hence the two triangles are similar. What does it mean if triangle A, B, C and triangle D, E, F, let's say, in this, if corresponding angles, for example, that is angle A should be equal to angle D, angle B should be equal to angle E, and angle C should be equal to angle F. So these two triangles will be called as similar triangles by using AA criteria, AAA criteria, or you can directly write only AA criteria. And what does this second statement say in this theorem 6.2? That is, their corresponding sides are in the ratio. That means if two triangles are similar, their sides will be proportional, that is AB upon this side is will be proportional divided by this side, that is DE will be equals to AC upon DF, AC upon DF will be equals to BC upon EF, BC upon EF. Okay, here in 6.3 theorem, what does it mean? Only if three angles are equal, corresponding angles of two triangles are equal, then that triangle will be similar. And if the triangle is similar, we know their sides will be proportional. Let's explain this. It will not come into the exam because it is in a criteria written in the form of theorem only. So let's derive it quickly. Whether if the three angles are congruent, corresponding as a congruent, then we can get this or not. This we will check this. Okay, to understand this, let's see in this figure. In triangle ABC, triangle ABC and triangle DEF, if angle A is congruent to angle D, angle B is congruent to angle E, angle C is congruent to angle F is given, we know it will be similar. Just we have to check whether if these three angles are equal, we are getting this or not. It will not come into your exam. Just for the sake of understanding, a proper level of understanding, we are explaining it. And those students who are only focusing on the exam, they can proceed to skip the video for 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, let's start. Let's draw DP, which should be equals to AB. So we have found out the point P, which is equidistant from D of the length of same as length B. Now take point Q on DF, which is at an equal distance, equal to distance AC. Got this? Now join PQ. So here you can write, take DP equals to AB on D and DQ equals to AC on DF, then join PQ. Getting it? You have joined this. Now you can observe in this two triangle, triangle ABC 1 and triangle DPQ, triangle 2. In triangle A, triangle ABC and triangle DPQ, what you can observe? AB is equals to, that is congruent to DP. From the construction we have did this, AC will be congruent to DQ, right? Getting it? Now, as you can observe, in triangle ABC and DEF, what was given? Angle A is equals to angle D. Let me write this here. What was given? Angle A congruent to angle D, angle B congruent to angle E, angle C congruent to angle F. Right? Now from figure you can observe, if now also you can see angle A is equal to angle D is given, right? Angle A congruent to angle D is given. That means this angle 1 and triangle 1 and 2 will be congruent by using side angle side theorem. And if two triangles, let me write this, triangle ABC will be congruent to triangle DPQ by using side angle side theorem or criteria, whatever SAS test will write, SAS test. Now if two triangles are congruent, that means their corresponding angles will be congruent. So angle B will be congruent to angle P and angle C will be congruent to angle Q, right? So let me write this, angle B will be congruent to angle B will be congruent to angle P and angle C will be congruent to angle Q. This is your second and this will be of first part of a triangle. Now here you can observe, if angle B is equals to angle E and angle B again from second, angle B is equals to angle P, that means angle E and angle P are equal, right? Here you can observe left hand side is equal, so right hand side will be also equal. Now what I can write, from 1 and 2 angle P is congruent to angle E, again angle C is equals to angle Q and angle C is equals to angle F, left hand side is equal, that why right hand side will be also equal. So what I can write, angle Q is angles equals to angle F. Now see in figure, here what we have seen, these angles are congruent, we have shown these angles. Okay, let me erase it to have a proper understanding. ठीक है, हियर यू कैन ऑब्जर्व एंगल पी इज कॉन्ग्रोन टू एंगल ई एंड एंगल क्यू इज कॉन्ग्रोन टू एंगल एफ, राइट। नाउ बाय यूजिंग कॉन्वर्स ऑफ करस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल थ्योरम, व्हिच इज एंगल्स आर कॉन्ग्रोन्ट, दैट मीन्स साइड पी, लाइन पी क्यू एंड लाइन पी ई एफ विल बी पैरेलल। आई बिलीव ऑल ऑफ यू नो दिस। If two lines are parallel and one line is intersecting them, that and these angles will be equal, and these angles are called as corresponding angles. Now, in the same way, that is the converse of this corresponding angle. If these angles are same, that means these two lines are parallel. This we have seen in our 9th standard. So, from this, let me name it 3. So from 3 we can write, PQ is parallel to your EF. PQ is parallel to EF. Now let me draw the triangle DEF again. Triangle DEF. This is my PQ. As PQ is parallel to EF, we can apply BPT in this triangle. So, in triangle DEF by basic proportionality theorem, what we can write? DP upon P will be equals to DQ upon QF. Getting it? Now just apply component. First we will apply invertendo. Invertendo. What I will get? P upon DP equals to QF upon DQ. What is invertendo? If A upon B is equals to C upon D, and you have to apply invertendo, that means just replace or switch the position of numerator and denominator. Make denominator as numerator, numerator as denominator on both sides. Getting it? The same added here. Now just apply component. What is component? If A upon B is equals to C upon D, component, just add denominator to numerator and keep denominator as it is. So same way we are going to apply here. P plus DP upon DP will be equals to QF upon DQ. Right? Sorry, this I have to add. By componendo. Now you can see P plus DP, what it is? This DP plus P will be D and DQ plus QF will be DF. Just write it. So what you will get? DE upon DP equals to DF upon DQ. Just remove the same name. DE, DF will be there. Here P is equal. So name will be DE. Okay, now again apply invertendo. Invertendo by applying invertendo. What you can see here? Again, DP upon DE equals to DQ upon DF. Right? Now, let's suppose this is R4. Now we know that DP is equals to your AB and DQ is equals to your AC, that we have done in our construction. DP is equals to AB, DQ is equals to AC. Here you can observe. So I can write, replace DP by AB and DQ by AC. So just replace DP by AB and DQ by AC. write other as it is. Here you can observe we have proved if two triangles are similar by using your AA test. And I will not divide it. If two triangles are similar, here triangle ABC and triangle DEF, by using their AA test, then their corresponding sides AB upon DE, AC upon DF, and similarly BC upon EF, you can also prove, are proportional. That is BC upon EF. Similarly, you can prove. So in this way, we have proved if two triangles are similar by using AA test or any test, two triangles are similar, then their corresponding sides are also proportional. So just remember this. Now coming to the next theorem, it is not a theorem, the criteria, side criteria of similarity is written in the form of theorem. What does it say? If in two triangles sides of one triangle are proportional to the sides of the other triangle in same ratio, then the proportional means the ratio is same, then their corresponding angles are equal and hence two triangles are similar. Converse that we have seen now, you can prove the same, just use the converse. Here what does it says? If in triangle ABC and DEF, AB upon DE and AC upon DF equals to BC upon EF is given, that is sides are in proportion, this side and this side are in proportion, that means that these two triangles will be similar. And if the two triangles are similar, corresponding angles will be congruent. Getting it? This angle C will be congruent to angle F. We are not going to prove this. This will be homework for you. And it is not that much of important of that proof. It is not important, but you have to just remember, if the ratio is equal, sides triangle is congruent by using SSS criteria. If the angles are congruent, all the angles, corresponding angles, then those two triangles will be congruent by using AA test. Now the third test or third criteria, we can say, what does it say? In one angle, if one angle of a triangle, let's suppose A, B, C, again D, E, F, sorry, D, E, F, one angle is congruent. So let's write angle A is congruent to angle D, and the other two sides forming these angles, that means here you can see angle A is formed by AB and AC, angle D is formed by DE and DF. The other two sides should be in proportion. That means AB upon DE, AB upon DE and AC upon DF should be equal. Okay. And if such criteria is there or such condition is there, so we can directly write triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. This symbol is for similarity of criteria, similarity. Okay. So just remember these three criteria, how two triangles can be similar. If any criteria is satisfied by two triangles, then those two triangles will be called as similar triangles. To understand these three criteria, let's take three examples depending on each one criteria.